What's going on, guys? It's K-Dub here with another episode of Crypto Zombie. So today is Sunday. Welcome back to the channel. Hope you've been having an awesome weekend so far. Having a look at what is going on, Bitcoin is basically still going sideways, but the altcoins are having a little bit of a mini rally today. So I do want to talk about that because altcoins have definitely been taking quite a beating lately. So are they finally looking for a major bounce back? Well, the last time that altcoins outperformed Bitcoin, they outperformed Bitcoin for about a day, and then they dumped super hard, and then all of those profits went back into Bitcoin. So is that going to happen again today? We're going to talk about that. I do want to discuss the short-term price action because currently Bitcoin is in a very critical zone. It's just bouncing around. We're going to talk about that as well. Also, there were 23,000 Bitcoin that got moved by whales, or some are speculating that it could be the Plus Token scammers looking to maybe get ready to dump their crypto on exchanges. We're going to talk about that. Also, we have China's Shenzhen economic zone, right? They're looking into cryptocurrency research. And also, I want to talk about one thing in regards to BACT that a lot of people tend to overlook, which I think is going to be absolutely massive. And pretty much the next time that this thing has a major move to the upside, we are not going to be seeing some of these lower levels ever again. If that sounds good to you, well, you know what to do. Also, don't forget, today is the last day for the Ledger Nano S giveaway that we do tomorrow. All you have to do is drop a comment on any video. You are eligible. That being said, let's dive in. Let's have a look. Let's give this a quick refresh live, actually. So, ooh, Bitcoin dominance pulling back. 68.5%. Look at these altcoins taking off. 5% Ethereum, 6% XRP. We actually talked about XRP yesterday and said, how is this thing still going lower, right? Look, Bitcoin Cash, 3%, 3% for Litecoin. Tether's obviously down today, so very good day for the alts today. Having a look at the biggest gainers, we have Rift Token up 19%, Hypercash, Japan Content, Beam, Qtum, Zcash, Nexo, Verge. So nice day for the altcoins today. Having a look at what's going on in the markets, you are seeing mild buy, strong buy, and a mild buy, with the shorts and the longs basically split down the middle. So very indecisive for Bitcoin. Looks like the altcoins are having some fun today. Let's dive in. Let's have a look. Now, this is what I was talking about. Currently on the daily, Bitcoin is trapped between this 100 moving average and this 50 moving average. And this is really starting to play out as sort of a very important level, because as we begin to get squished between the two, as they get closer and closer, it's gonna really put Bitcoin into a bit of a pickle, if you know what I mean. So having a look over here, also flipping it, looking at the 200 moving average on the 4 hour, this is also a really big deal for Bitcoin. So not only do we have this situation happening over here, we also have this situation happening where not only are we being held down by that, but we're also being squished between this support where we've had a few touches, you know, basically, we touched it at around this $9,800 level. We wicked down into the red zone, but you know, like I said, it is starting to put more and more pressure on Bitcoin. So where could we be going moving forward? Well, that's kind of what I wanted to talk about. You see, currently we are in the green, all right? We're $10,442 inside of the EMA ribbon. So this is good. We would like to get above the ribbon, because once we get above it, that's usually when we tend to blast off, right? So fingers crossed, but currently we are still struggling. You can see right here, we are sort of in no man's land. We are out of the danger zone. If we were to fall below this sort of $10,200 level, then that would put us back into this red zone, and we might be looking at lower lows. You will notice one thing, however, I do want to point out the VPVR. We have the strongest amount of volume right here at around $11,389. Now, I think once we get above this, which I don't think it'll be hard to, I think we'll have more difficulty, you know, breaking some of these other resistances. You'll notice the only resistance that we have after that, we have volume at around 11,800, that $11,700, $11,800 level that we've been talking about. But once we get above that $12,000, there's really not much going on here. And if we can put in a higher high, basically, or at least higher than this $12,300 level, then I do think we'd be seeing a lot bluer skies ahead. However, on the bearish side, falling below that would be a bad thing. You can see right here, currently we did put in two green dots on the market cipher over here. There was a nice opportunity for a long. Currently, there is a little bit of red X's being put in. So if you were able to get into that, just be safe. You know, obviously, you know, don't get greedy on these longs and shorts. That's usually what tends to ruin it, right? That greed. But I do want to just once again mention, going back to the charts, that if we do have a look at this, we could fall below here to some of those lower levels. But that being said, I wanted to also talk about the altcoins, because we are seeing altcoins pump today. Well, you could see the altcoins fell below the 200 moving average, okay? Now, altcoins themselves are also finding that they are wedged between the 200 and the 100. Now, the thing I want to notice is that you do have the 50 that moved below the 100 on the daily. Now, this is for altcoins. So this signals a bit of a death cross. And you notice as soon as we had that, the altcoins fell below the 200. Now, if we come back over here, you'll notice we put in a golden cross, okay? And then we put in a second golden cross here. And as soon as we were able to get above it, actually, if you look, basically, as soon as we got above the 200 back here, that was when altcoins really popped off, okay? So we are having a very interesting time ahead. That's why I said it's going to be very turbulent. Long-term charts are looking great. Short-term, well, like I said yesterday, we may need one last fake out, right? But I do want to talk about 5,000 Bitcoin that got moved, another 5,000 Bitcoin that got moved, 6,000 Bitcoin that got moved, and another 7,000 Bitcoin that got moved as well by whales. So what does this mean? Are we going to have a major dump incoming? Why are the whales moving this? Well, it is speculated that the recent Bitcoin transactions are likely from the Plus Token scam, but Whale Alert has yet to confirm it. So currently, should we be panicking and freaking out about 23,000 Bitcoin being moved? I mean, possibly. Okay? It may be from the scammers, though. It may not be from institutions looking to dump. In fact, a lot of people thought that it was the institutions, but I'm going to tell you, I don't think it is. The reason being that you could just see right here, you have Coinbase's founder, Brian Armstrong, and look, he's even pictured at an office that they're rebuilding. They're constructing something new. So obviously, they must be doing fine financially. It doesn't look like they're hurting. He says, we didn't know whether institutions were going to adopt cryptocurrency or not. That was the big question 12 months ago. Now, he says, I think it's safe to say that we know the answer. We're seeing $200 to $400 million a week in new crypto deposits coming in from institutional customers. Back in May, he even mentioned the fact that they had about 60% of the trading volumes on Coinbase Pro coming from institutional traders. So I think this is definitely showing us that the masses are interested. Now, we cannot ignore the elephant in the room. Bakkt is huge and it is coming and it is launching September 23rd. A lot of people don't seem to understand what is the significance of this. I don't get it. We already have different ways of trading futures and stuff like that, right? Well, it's not exactly the same. I could break it down for you. I've broken it down for you multiple times, but I'm actually going to turn it over to the Wolf of All Streets. Now, what he says is the Bakkt news is arguably the most bullish event for institutional investors in the history of Bitcoin. Physically delivered futures require the holder to either produce actual Bitcoin or take delivery from the exchange, okay, which would be backed by the New York Stock Exchange. He says, we are maturing. Now, how does this differ from regular futures like the CME? Well, those are cash settled, right? So you don't actually have to ever physically touch any Bitcoin, ever, okay? That does not create demand. Futures contracts that are cash settled are not delivered, right? He says, also, I would like to know how much Bitcoin Bakkt has already accumulated, because I would certainly assume that they had something to do with, you know, this pump we've been seeing. I'm sure there's been massive institutional accumulation in the background. I mean, even Grayscale said, you know, they own over 1%, and I think they were trying to take about 21% of the Bitcoin that was being mined. So you could definitely see the demand. It was either 21 or 27%. It was some astronomical number. So many of us said that this bull run was different because it happened without retail interest or FOMO. Price rose steadily from $3,200 to about $14,000 without media hype. Our hypothesis was that it was a result of institutional investment. He says, I think that hypothesis was correct. Now, people were scared, right? They said, well, this is just going to give them more opportunity to short it. But like we said, it's physically settled. For example, if we go back to, you can just Google this. I literally Googled Bitcoin CME futures launch date, December 18th of 2017. That was the day that we finally had the opportunity to institutionally, I'm not talking about BitMEX and all that, institutionally to short Bitcoin. However, it was cash settled. And as you guys know how history played out, well, that green arrow represents the exact day that the futures were launched, one day after Bitcoin's all-time high. Do you think that was a coincidence? I certainly don't. In fact, I also think it was a reason why Bakkt was dragged out for so long. I do believe there's a bit of a conspiracy going on with that. How come Ledger X, which actually applied earlier, got shot down, or at least they're saying it went too long, or I don't even really know what's going on with it right now. They went over the time limit or something. Well, what is it about Bakkt that got pushed back, but now got approved by the CFTC and from New York as well? Very interesting. We could talk about that. But what did they do? Well, they eventually shorted Bitcoin for the next year. Okay? You don't think somebody knew what was happening? So I just wanted to point that out. But what I do want to say is, once again, reiterating it, why is Bakkt so important? It is because Bakkt is physically settled. For example, if you trade on Bybit, okay, you have to, if you want to trade Bitcoin, you have to deposit Bitcoin. If you want to trade Ethereum, well, you have to deposit Ethereum, right? And you get paid out in Ethereum, right? If you want to deposit XRP, if you want to trade XRP, you have to deposit XRP. And hopefully you don't get liquidated, but if you do make a profit, then you will be paid in XRP. This creates more demand for the tokens. You're not just betting, you know, with cash, right? So yeah, wow, guys, look at this. Wow, it came all the way down to 23 cents. So congratulations to anybody that got in that long for XRP, but man, been really, really crazy. I knew it was gonna pump. I mean, it was just, how could you take a hit like that and not spring back? But anyway, that being said, I think I'm getting off topic here. I think you can understand why the Bakkt futures are going to have such a positive impact on Bitcoin as compared to what we saw with the CME futures, okay? That's basically my point being said. Also, if you guys are unfamiliar with how to trade futures or how to use Bybit, there actually was this really good tutorial that came out from Crypto Potato. They gave it a 9.6. I agree, great liquidity, user experience is really good, security. So if you want, yes, unfortunately, they are back to the regular $10, $50 sign up. The promotion is over, but check it out. You can see how to register, how to deposit, limit order, market order. And the only reason that I'm pointing this out is I did make a video for this, which I'll drop above for you guys right now, but some people might be better if you just want to read it. So if you're interested in learning how to use Bybit, you could definitely check that below. Also guys, friendly reminder, I do have a referral link below. It does help the channel out. It doesn't cost you anything extra, but I do appreciate it. And it allows me to continue to bring all of this free content out every single day. But got off topic, getting back onto Bitcoin, okay? Bitcoin may not be the world reserve currency, right? Let's be objective here. Maybe it won't be the end all be all. But I think certainly given our current economic and political turmoil, especially what we're seeing in these countries, all-time highs in Venezuela and Argentina, okay, and what's happening in Turkey, right? You are seeing the absolute desperate need for Bitcoin. And I kind of just wanted to turn it over to Saifedean Amos over here and just let him sort of explain a little bit about why I think, he calls Bitcoin monetary Batman. So let me just let him explain this first.
And, you know, if it's Venezuela, if it sets an example for Venezuela that more and more Venezuelans start moving, let's say, towards Bitcoin, then it forces a bankruptcy of the current socialist kleptocracy in Venezuela. And then a new government that comes along in Venezuela will know that, you know, if we mess around, people can just defect from here to Bitcoin. Maybe Bitcoin doesn't end up being adopted all over the world. Maybe it doesn't end up being a new monetary standard, but it acts as a sort of, the metaphor I gave is a sort of monetary Batman lurking in the shadows of every society so that, you know, anytime a government begins to inflate, people can just start moving towards it. And as they start moving towards it, you know, because the supply is limited, the value rises. So it's a very attractive notion for people to start jumping onto it. So maybe it's just going to be this, you know, this bad guy that is going to force discipline on governments.
Maybe it is just going to be the monetary Batman, right? But the other thing too is a lot of people are like, yeah, but you know, if we start to adopt it, look what happens. Look at all the transactions. Look at the mempool. It gets backed up. You know, fees absolutely skyrocket. You have to wait hours to send your Bitcoin. This thing will never work. Well, actually, guys, if I get out of the way right now and you have a look, we have actually been putting in volume very similar to what we've seen back in 2017, and yet we're only putting in mere fractions of what we were doing to the mempool back in 2017. So this just shows me that the network is maturing, the network is getting stronger, and we are able to actually hold these transactions and not have to make people wait. Oh, also, other thing, don't forget, SegWit adoption is now close to 50%. 3%, okay? So that also has a lot to do with it, right? You're seeing a lot of the addresses with the number 3 in front of it. I know there's more to it than that, but I'm just kind of oversimplifying it for people that are just in it. Also, kind of funny story. Andreas Antonopoulos says the IRS is using very advanced investigation techniques. They have information that leads them to believe I may have cryptocurrency. Say it ain't so. Such sleuthing. Wow. P.S. I reported and paid all my taxes properly. They're casting a very wide net, blindly, cheap and easy. So essentially, if you did get this letter from the IRS, yes, you should respond, but no, don't freak out unless you got that really serious one that's like, you know, you have to respond within a few days. Basically, they're sending this out to everyone as a blanket. Most people are just getting this, okay? I think what they're doing is just kind of just like throwing out the hook and just seeing who will take it, right? So that's basically that situation moving forward. But Satoshi Nakamoto to reveal himself. What? I should have mentioned this earlier in the video. So it looks like we have yet another individual person, entity, coming out saying they're Satoshi. Last time we had the big Satoshi reveal, it was basically just the website for Project Pi News. So currently we have another one saying that he's going to release himself after a decade of anonymity. Part one of his My Reveal is going to happen today. Actually, a few hours from the time I'm making this video. So if you're watching this video after 4 p.m. Eastern time, well, then he apparently already revealed himself and you already know about this. So apparently he's going to reveal himself on this website, Satoshi NRH, where they ask you to enter your email and subscribe. So that sounds like something Satoshi would definitely do. Also, the other website that they are that Satoshi's going to be revealing himself on is Ivy Macklemore, like the rapper Macklemore and Associates. Why would he specifically pick this website to debut himself? I have no idea. Scrolling down here, you could see that their clients include Satoshi Nakamoto. So interesting. Renaissance Holdings. We'll have to see about that. But like Charlie Lee said, Satoshi Nakamoto brought to this world an open source, decentralized, trustless, censorship resistant currency based on math and cryptography. If Satoshi wanted to reveal himself, he would sign a message with the Genesis key. Anything short of that is most likely fraudulent. But that being said, guys, there was this tweet that came out from Weiss Crypto Ratings. If you had to choose between these four, which would be your favorite? IOTA? Beating out Bitcoin? 46%? 38% Bitcoin? Let me know, guys. Would you choose IOTA over Bitcoin? I don't know. Then again, who even pays attention to Weiss ratings? But probably one of the most significant things that came out in the news today was the Shenzhen Special Economic Zone now supporting the inclusion of digital currency research. According to the Chinese media reports, the Central Committee of the Communist Party of the China and State Council issued opinions on supporting Shenzhen to build a pilot demonstration zone for socialism with Chinese characteristics. Wow, don't think I've ever said Communist Party and socialism in the same sentence on this channel, but there's always a first time for everything. Supporting innovative applications such as digital money research and mobile payment in Shenzhen. And really quick, just super quick altcoin news. NIO is considering integrating Seller Network's Layer 2 scaling protocol to improve their scalability. Interestingly enough, I did not know this, but according to the report, community members say that Seller is 15 times faster than Bitcoin's Lightning Network. I knew it was fast. I didn't know it was that fast, though. That's pretty incredible. I actually did do an interview with Seller Network, if you're curious. Just Google it, or just search it, you know, Crypto Zombie Seller Network. We did it over a year ago, if you guys are interested. But ending on some funny news, CZ had an interesting interaction with a 14-year-old today. He refused to discuss numbers in USD and instead on BNB numbers. The next generation will be crypto native. A lot of people are basically saying, no, this didn't happen. You're calling this out. I saw a lot of people making fake tweets emulating this as well. Peter McCormick says, I hope you referred him to the Binance Terms of Service, which say you must be at least 18 years or older. Travis Walker from ARK, he says, this is a stretch and you know you didn't need to tweet this. Yeah, I'll take crap that never happened for 2000. Thanks, Alex. So yeah, that's kind of the funny news for the end of the day. But that is that's the news today, guys. It is Sunday. Hope you are enjoying your weekend. It's a little bit of an ugly day here in New York, but I'm ready for Monday, guys. I am ready to start the week off. I'm ready to get back on the grind and give away our Ledger Nano S tomorrow. So once again, thank you again to everyone that stopped by. I hope you guys found some value out of this video. If you did, definitely